have Peter Schubel, who is a retired fireman, and he is a lecturer at the University of New Haven. Thank you for being on the show.
It's my pleasure.
So tell me, what was your first job and how old were you?
Well, I was a very young 16 years old, and my first job was at a grocery store called Suburban Foods on the west side of Wallingford.
You know, how did you get this first job?
Well, interestingly enough, that I have three older brothers, and all of my older brothers worked at that grocery store at one time in their lives, usually when they were 16 and 17, and then graduated from high school. So, you know, one of the advantages I had was at a very young age, what we call a network.
Yeah.
They knew who I was, and they knew my family, and they knew my brothers. So it gave me kind of the foot in the door to at least get a interview to be able to get a job there at 16.
Were there any transportation issues? Did you walk there? Did you get a ride? Or
the grocery store was about a mile from my house, and it was between my house and Sheehan High School.
Okay.
So I was able to walk from the high school to the grocery store after the day at the high school, and then if it was a weekend, it was close enough to my house where I was able to walk. I didn't get a car until I was 18, so the whole time I worked there, I was pretty much my transportation was walking.
So was your first job what you expected it to be?
I thought it was actually better, because up till that point when I was 16, you know, I did odd things like cut lawns. I helped as a kind of a laborer around construction sites. It was very physically demanding work.
Yeah.
And when I got into a real job, my real first part-time job, I found that the work wasn't quite as physically demanding. The pay was certainly better. So I was actually pleasantly surprised when I started with it.
Tell me, what was your most memorable experience at your first job?
Well, I mean, it was a grocery store, you know, clerk, bagger, stock thing, and the one thing that I was able to do was meet a lot of people from town, because on the west side of town, at the time, that's where everybody shopped.
Yeah.
And as I grew older and I got onto the fire department here in Wallingford, I actually would see a lot of my original customers that I saw in the grocery store when I was on the fire department. So, and they always remembered me, and you know, from working at the grocery store. And I thought that was kind of unique.
What did you want to be when you grew up? Anything in particular?
Well, I mean, I think the spark was always there to go on to the fire department ever since I was probably about 5 years old. And, you know, I became a volunteer firefighter here in Wallingford when I was 16. So when I was working at the grocery store, I was still a volunteer firefighter. But I always kind of knew in the back of my mind that that was really my first love for a job.
Yeah.
So, you know, and when I became 18, I did an associate's degree in a different subject, worked in that for a little while, but ultimately I landed on the fire department as a firefighter paramedic.
So you ended up, you know, accomplishing that goal?
Yeah, I ended up where I thought I'd be. When I was younger, I didn't really think too much about becoming a supervisor or an officer or a chief of a department. I really thought, you know, once I became a firefighter, that would be good enough. But then once I got on the fire department, the drive and the push became to become a supervisor with that fire department.
Did lessons that you learned from your first job influence your future work experience?
Well, I think so. It has a lot to do with showing respect for your coworkers, and I always say customer service, because your customers are both the people who shop at the store and the people that you work with. People always need something from you. Your coworkers need something from you. So I think I took that lesson into everything I've done since then. It's about doing things for other people that you work with and doing things for your customers.
So if you could use only one word to describe your first job, what would that would be?
I think it's educational, because being the first job, you're on a learning curve, and you're learning to apply some basic things that you have as a person to a workplace. So I would say educational.
So if you could do that first job over again, would you?
At 16 years old, I wouldn't change a thing. I would do exactly what I did. I thought it allowed me to put money in the bank. It allowed me to, you know, to start saving. It allowed me to get some valuable work skills. So I wouldn't change it to anything at 16 years old.
So you're a retired fireman. So do you have any, you know, stories that you want to share? Anything in interest?
I spent 28 years as a career firefighter, another 7 as a volunteer, so grand total of about 35 years on the fire service here in Wallingford. Incredibly rewarding, sad at times because see, you know, people that are having the worst day of their life, and then very happy at other times when, you know, you get to see a baby born or some, you know, new child coming into the world. So, I can't even describe how rewarding the experience was for 35 years being associated with the fire department. Yeah. And it prepared me for now the next chapter of my life, which is teaching at a university in paramedicine and fire science.
So our last question would be, you know, do you have any success tips for the people that are seeking their first job?
Absolutely. I think the key is, and I talk to my kids at the university about this all the time when they go to interview for jobs, it's preparation. If you know you're going to go for your job interview on Wednesday, you need to do a practice run on Tuesday. You need to know where the job interview is, what the traffic's like, where you park, so you can be on time and you're not stressed when you get there. And then the other key thing that I always tell my kids is know your resume, because your resume is basically your elevator pitch for who you are. If you know your resume and you can walk through your resume, you're going to sound organized. You're going to be able to tell that prospective employer who you are in a very concise time frame.
Well, folks, there you have it. Peter Schubel, our retired fireman, now lecturer at the University of New Haven. Thank you for sharing your stories and your first job. It was nice having you on the show.
Thank you, Hamza.